Part of the polls are any indication, Tony Abbott is set to win office after 6 years in opposition. And Mr. Abbott joins us live now. Mr. Abbott, thanks for your time. Why do you deserve to be Steve. Prime Minister?
Well, first of all, Steve, there are no massive cuts. The Prime Minister is just engaging in a big scare, which shows that he has nothing positive to say about the future and no record to defend. But look, Stephen, if you want to see a government which builds a stronger economy so that everyone can get ahead, which scraps the carbon tax, which ends the waste, which stops the boats and builds roads like EastLink, you've got to change the government. And that means voting for your Liberal and National Coalition candidates tomorrow.
Are you nervous slashed worried that just about everyone is declaring you a certainty tomorrow?
I don't believe the polls. And I think we're basically at three-quarter time in the grand final and there's only a goal in it. And that's why it's really important that people don't waste their vote. They don't dilly-dally with independents and minor parties. If you want to change the government, if you want to ensure that we don't have three more years like the last six, you've got to vote for your Liberal and National Party coalition candidate in the House and in the Senate.
Mr. Abbott, the Liberal Party likes to promote its economic credentials, so why won't you reveal when the budget will return to surplus?
What we did demonstrate last week and again this week is that the budget bottom line will always be better off under the coalition. But there are no cuts to health, no cuts to education, no changes to pensions, and no changes to the GST. And Mr. Rudd is frankly engaging in a campaign of barefaced lies when he suggests otherwise. It's really sad that the Prime Minister of this country can do nothing after 6 years of government but run a scare campaign.
Mr. Abbott, thank you for talking to 10 News.